When Thomas arrived back at Titmouth Shed, he looked around, but he couldn't see Percy anywhere. He didn't know which berth he could be in. Percy! Percy! Where are you, Percy? There's something I need to tell you! Then, he noticed that there was a notice on Percy's shed door. Its driver took it off and read it. Dear entrance at Titmouth, by the time you read this, I will have left to the mainland. I want some time to myself to think about what I've done. I don't want to be the cause of you lot having any more accidents, and I'm sorry, Thomas. I want you to go and prove to the railway what I already know, that you're the greatest friends anyone could ever have, and you live on the best railway of all time, your old friend, Percy. Thomas felt bad. Oh man, I didn't want him to leave, he puffed sadly. I'm sure Percy isn't running away, Thomas. He'll be safe. He just wants some time to himself, said its driver. I know Percy is accident prone, but it's never a stupid engine. Well, except when you were planning a surprise party for Bill and Ben last week. Let's celebrate with music and fireworks! Yes, invite the navigation engines, and bring Robert, Felix and Rocco too! Yes, and get Cranky to lift us up to the hills and celebrate there! Percy, that's a silly idea, because the boat arrives at the docks, not the hills. Well, at least it's on the railway. I think he'll be safe. But Thomas was still worried. So he decided to see if the navigation engines had seen him. He arrived at the transfer yards. Hello, Thomas, said the engines. Hello, everyone, Thomas puffed. Have any of you not seen Percy? No, sorry, Thomas, said Reneus. He hasn't been passed, finished Scarlery. Why? It's just that he ran away because I've been hard on him. I'm worried he might stop being my friend. Well, I'm guessing one of the reasons he ran away, put in Sir Handel, is because Duncan told Percy to tell you lot to get Cranky to lift you up to the hills and celebrate here, even though the boat is coming to the docks. Oh, very funny, Sir Handel, grumbled Duncan. I'm sure Percy will be alright, puffed Scarlery, and I've told you that a boat will be coming to the docks. It's not just Percy that's disappeared, said Musty. Why? Asked Thomas. Because Stepney's gone missing too. What? Cried the engines. Bust my buffers, gasped Peter Sam. Does this mean we have an engine napper on the loose? He was mummied. I'm afraid so, Peter Sam, so we better be careful, puffed Scarlery. And don't mummy, Thomas, puffed Reneus. I'm sure Percy will come back when he's ready. He's a brave engine, remember? I suppose so, Thomas puffed. But I just wish I could have had a chance to apologise to him before he left. But I'm going to keep an eye out for him and Stepney. I'll see you a lot later. Okay, Thomas. See ya. And Thomas puffed sadly back to the sheds. That night at the sheds, the news spread about Stepney's disappearance went to the other engines, and they were all talking about it. Something tells me that there's an engine napper on the loose, so we must be careful, puffed Edward. There is one thing I can take in from today, puffed Henry. Which is what? Asked Gordon. Well, as you would have expected, I've done the express properly and I've proven myself better than you at the express. Well, you pulled it in good time, puffed Gordon. Are my shape is better, are my tendons better, and my wheels are better. Looks isn't everything, puffed Gordon. Is it not? Fumed Henry. Well, spluttered Gordon. He didn't know what to say.
What are we gonna do? Asked Emily. We can't stay here with an engine napper on the loose.
Thomas stayed unusually quiet. He was still worried about Percy. None of the other engines knew about Percy's disappearance because the notice was off the door. He felt worse than ever.
Shh, puffed Duck. I can hear an engine coming.
And Spencer came up.
Evening, everyone, he puffed.
The engines gasped.
It's him,
gasped Emily.
Good evening, everyone, puffed Spencer. What are you all up to? He asked.
The engines were very cross. They all thought Spencer was the culprit.
You're a monster, Spencer, puffed Gum. You think you could kidnap engines and get away with it?
Yeah, we were friends with that Bluebell engine, fumed Henry crossly.
What are you talking about?
Asked Spencer. He looked puzzled.
You're going to be in trouble, I can tell,
finished Henry.
What did I do?
Asked Spencer crossly.
You kidnapped Stepney so that you could be part of a railway show yourself. Are you going to do the same thing to us?
No, I won't. I've only just been practicing for the race for the show. Why would I do that?
If I were you, puffed Gordon, I'd keep your mouth shut until we get you to sheriff tomorrow.
I didn't kidnap anybody, fumed Spencer crossly.
Then, suddenly, all the lights went out.
The engines gasped.
Then suddenly, there was a buffering noise and a purring noise fading out of the yard. By the time the noise stopped, the lights came back on. The engines looked around.
Look! Gasped Stanley.
Spencer was nowhere to be seen.
Spencer's gone! Gasped Emily.
Oh great, I bet he ran away so he could get away with this mystery, puffed Gordon.
I don't think so, Gordon, puffed Duck. I can hear buffering noise and a purring noise of an engine. And would a steam engine leave oil? Look on that track, finished Duck, looking at a patch of oil on Spencer's track.
This means Spencer isn't a culprit, it's a diesel engine.
The engines were cross. They had put up with diesel experience before.
Oh, now I hope I get kidnapped next, fumed Henry crossly.
Don't say that, Henry! You're scaring us!
Fumed Emily.
Sorry, I was just a bit cross and mummied, that's all,
Henry puffed.
We all are, added Edward. And if we don't find out who the culprit is soon, they're all going to be gone before the show starts.
Gordon sighed, and he muttered a quiet,
good night.
But no one responded. They were all lost in their thoughts. Some of the other men just decided to stay together with the engines at Titmouth for the night. But they were so mummied that they were struggling to go to sleep.
I need some sleep. You can't go on like this. I tried counting sheep, but there's one I always miss.
Thomas didn't even try to go to sleep.
What if Percy isn't safe? What if he ends up being scrapped on the mainland?
Thomas was mummied. Percy, on the other hand, was alright. He was at the carrot shed at Ellsbridge. He had found the perfect coaches and maybe a brake van to help with Lightning the Mater's special project.
I'm gonna make the engines really proud of me by helping Lightning the Mater with this by myself. Then we'll see what a really clever engine I am.
Then he puffed happily to sleep, unaware of what a mystery is about to happen.
The engines were still mummied for the next morning as they set out to work.
Stanley whispered to Duck,
I wish the Fat Controller it didn't organise a railway show,
he puffed sadly.
But it's still a good idea, Stanley, puffed Duck. And don't worry, no matter what happens, we're Sodor engines and we always stick together. That means we'll be safe.
If you're sure, Duck,
yawned Stanley, and he puffed sleepily away to Great Waterton.
Yes, so me, puffed Duck, we're Sodor engines, and no matter what happens, we always stick together.
Duck gave out a great big yawn, and he soon fell fast asleep.
Meanwhile, Thomas had to pick up some passengers. As he waited, he saw something.
he could see a glimpse of green appearing around the bend. It must Percy its bunker. He must reverse in the coaches out of the siding and was just about to set off to the mainland workshop. Something like the mater could start work. There's Percy! He is safe! Thomas puffed. He tried to whistle to him. Percy heard Thomas.
Oh no! He puffed. I can't let Thomas see me. It will spoil the surprise.
Percy didn't want Thomas to know what he was up to, so he puffed away quickly. Thomas was surprised. Percy didn't hang around. I wonder what he's up to. I better go and find out. Thomas secretly followed Percy. He puffed as quietly as he could, and he didn't follow too closely in case he scared him. Suddenly, Percy turned down one of the branch lines. This was the junction Percy had come down to the workshop first time round. Thomas raced after him, but just as he got to the junction, the signalman changed the points. Thomas had to go straight ahead. Bother! He puffed. He was so surprised that he nearly missed the next station. He screeched to a stop. Cinders and ashes! He grumbled. How will I ever find out what Percy's up to? Meanwhile, the Flying Scotsman could see that the other engines were still mummied. Cheer up, everyone. It's a beautiful day, he said. It's not beautiful because Stepney and Spencer have gone missing. There's an engine napper on the loose. And my boiler isn't sunny. It feels stuffed up, puffed Henry. Nasty fumes from being too puffed up about yourself, eh, Henry? Teased Gordon. You, spluttered Henry. Don't start, you two, Edward puffed. We haven't got time for this arguing. We need to work out who's behind all this. Yes, puffed Duck. If we're not careful, the show will have to be cancelled and the railway will close. Och, I don't know what you lot are moaning about, puffed Donald. I had a really good sleep. Sleep? With an engine napper on the loose? Oh, engine napper? Well, we better do something about it, puffed Donald. That's what we were discussing about, puffed Duck. If only there was someone we knew who can help us, sighed Edward. Someone who knows how to solve mysteries. Then, he had an idea. He explained it to the other engines, and they all agreed, and Edward's driver made to make a telephone call at once. Later that day, Thomas and James were at a level crossing. Just then, a streak of blue whirled right past them. Hello, Finn, called James. Hello, James, Finn called back. Finn? Asked Thomas, looking puzzled. You know, puffed James. Finn McMissile. I helped him to stop Professor C from taking over the world. Oh yeah, whistled Thomas. Now I remember. Yeah, said James. I got so popular, some animator from America heard about my adventure and turned it into an animated TV series. Except I'm a white dog, my voice is dubbed by this scary trainer guy, and my name is Dudley Puppy.
Kitty, I'm making this in pottery class! I call it the death of art. Actually, that's what the counselor called it. I thought it was a unicorn.
Uh-oh, Snapchat is sabotaging the camp canoes! We have to stop him!
Kitty, use the first aid button!
Ugh, I hate that show, muttered James. Although I thought that the death of art part was pretty funny.